Right, so this is a knitted star map of the night sky. It's a little bit big, so it's 2.8 meters tall by 4.4 meters wide. So it's not a small thing to carry in your luggage on a plane halfway around the world. So it's 15 kilos as well. It was a bit tricky getting on the plane. So we set up an ESP32 chip, which is listening to a AWS IoT trigger. It's got an onboard Wi-Fi. That blue light is actually telling me that it hasn't quite connected to AWS yet, so it's just working its way through. When the blue light turns off, I mean, it's fine. Let me tell you about knitting. I took a domestic knitting machine from the 1980s. We're talking really old school tech here, with a 32-bit onboard computer, and I hacked it to turn it into a modern day network printer. So there was a few hacks involved with that one. So first of all, I used a Raspberry Pi to interface between the onboard computer and my computer. So the Raspberry Pi is obviously sitting on the network and it's running a website, which I can connect to with my laptop in a completely different room. And then I can send it an image and it can process that image, give me a preview of what it'll look like in the knitted fabric. And then I can press print. And there's still a little bit of work involved in actually getting the print started physically with the knitting machine. You have to cast on. There's a bit of a process there. But once it's running, I've got a robot arm that's running it backwards and forwards to actually perform the knitting. And I also built, with the help from my husband, John Spencer, I built an automatic colour changer so I can do multiple colour knitting. So not just black and white, like multicolour knitting. On this old school knitting machine. Normally they're designed kind of like a sewing machine in the sense that you sit there and you actively engage with the machine and you are constantly manipulating it in order to produce the end result, which is the knitting. So in the efforts of automating it, I took out an entire process of creating knitting patterns. So I don't actually create a knitting pattern, I create an image and then the process will create the pattern for me. And I've automated the actual colour changing part, which means that I don't need to sit with the knitting machine at all once it's running. One of my major contributions to the knitting, machine knitting community was a whole new algorithm that I created to create one knit per pixel knitting in three colours. So that's something that these machines were never previously capable of doing, so I created a whole new algorithm in order to do that. And I think the main reason why no one had done it before is because it takes a lot of processing to sort of think through the problem and get it working. So I was able to create a few different algorithms, and then I, you know, being the computer scientist, I tested lots of different algorithms and I came up with one that had sort of the best results, which is the one you see behind me. Oh, there you go, there's Pisces going off. Before this piece was actually finished, I entered it into something called REAIO, which is a three-day hackathon that my work runs for over 3 days every quarter, which is amazing. I did a call out to get helpers to light up the constellations.
What else have you printed?
Mostly laptop covers, scarves, baby blankets. Yeah, so I've done a few things. Nothing quite this big though. So this was a bit intimidating, this particular project. I don't know too much about astronomy. I'm very much an amateur, but I plotted where the planets will line up on the actual knittings. They line up to a particular date and time. And I've been working on this project for a few months now, so I was kind of hoping that I would hit the deadline, and I did actually hit it. This tapestry was installed before 6 p.m. Friday the 31st, which is the day that EMF opened. This knitting was installed, ready to go, and the planets aligned at that time.
And tell me, could you see them, or was the cloud cover?
It was actually still daylight. But I did check that night. I did check a few hours later, and yeah, the moon was spot on. The planets were pretty much in the right spot. So, yeah, that was satisfying.
What happens to this now?
Oh right, a few people have asked me that question. I really want to keep it in the public domain somewhere. So I will be taking it home with me. So nothing's really finalised there yet, but hopefully people can actually come and see it and, like, you know, touch knitting. It's a fabric. It, you know, people need to touch it. So hopefully it'll stay in the public domain somewhere. It took a lot longer than I was hoping, mostly because I was having a problem with the yarn getting caught on the left side, right near the colour changer. So I mean, yarn is a fuzzy material.